If you want to create PowerPoint presentations using ChatGPT, but your PowerPoint doesn't have design ideas or designer, this video will help you out. Let's start by heading over to ChatGPT. Here is a prompt I used to get ChatGPT to generate VBA code for a presentation about record high temperatures around the world and how we can address this issue. Copy the VBA code. In PowerPoint, make sure you have the developer option enabled. Click on the developer tab, select Visual Basic and click on Model. Paste the code and hit run. If you get an error when you click run, you might want to watch this video where I cover common ChatGPT errors and how you can fix them. Now we've got 5 slides generated with the code. We don't have design suggestions because I've disabled designer from displaying any. So, if your PowerPoint doesn't have design ideas, here is what you can do. Go to designer.microsoft.com. You will need a Microsoft account to sign in. Scroll down to Design Creator and click on Generate. At the bottom of the page, select Skip and start with a blank design. Next, choose the page size for the design. PowerPoint slides are 1920 by 1080 pixels. And since that size is not in the list, select Custom Size. Enter 1920 in the field for width and click Create. Go back to PowerPoint and copy the title text from the opening slide. Back on Designer, click on Generate and paste or enter the text you just copied. Then click the forward arrow button to generate. It will take some time to compile images based on the text or prompt you've provided. And if you don't like the image suggestions, click the forward arrow again to generate another set of images. When it's ready, select an image and expand it to cover the page. Most of the time, design suggestions will appear automatically, but if you don't see them, click the icon in the top right corner to view design suggestions. From the list of suggestions, choose one and replace the text with your title text. As you are editing, more design suggestions are loaded for you. It's really helpful. If you change your mind, you can choose another design. This time, it comes with the text you entered on the page. When you are done, click on Download. Based on the content on the page, you can download it as a PNG, JPEG, or PDF. And because the page size is the same as a PowerPoint slide, you can insert the image on your slide without additional editing. If you decide to go with a design suggestion that has animations, you will be able to download the page as an MP4 and insert it as a video on your slide. I hope that sooner rather than later, Microsoft adds the option to download as a PowerPoint file. This will allow us to add animations and edit the content. Fingers crossed. Until then, keep creating amazing presentations.